Hi, wanna scan this QR code?
Stop!
Don't scan this QR code, you're gonna get rickrolled. But like, how can this blob of pixels even store the link to anything? Well, it's quite simple actually. You see, there are certain parts that are always the same, like these, which enable scanning devices to recognize them immediately. This is the actual data, which is stored in pixels, black or white. In other words, binary, so zeros and ones, which can then be understood by machines. Once it finds the orientation points, which is easiest if there is a quiet zone around the QR code, it knows everything within it is part of the code and it starts reading, which goes from bottom right upwards in a zigzag pattern before it comes down again in the next column. The first four pixels stand for the type of data: numeric, alphanumeric, binary, or kanji. After that, it's filled up with 4x2 blocks representing 1 byte with 8 bits, until you get to the end message block, which is just a block of 4 zeros, so 4 white pixels. Let's look at an example. If you wanted to store the uppercase letter K, which is this in ASCII binary, you would get this 4x2. Rinse and repeat, and you can pretty much store whatever you want. There's even error correction built into these, so you can lose like a third of it and it still works, plus they come in different sizes, which is like super useful, so yeah, these things are great. But hold on, why do they even exist?
Oh no, this barcode cannot store enough information, said some Japanese guy in a car factory, so they made them bigger and into a grid.
Wow, that worked.
Yes, it worked, and it's super fast, and people love them because they look cool. Also, they can turn this into that, so yeah, now they're everywhere.